And my girls and I have had a great time making and racing these cars. And in a moment, I'll show you how to make a basic one. Now, one of the things I love about these cars is they work just like a rocket. The air comes out the back and it pushes the vehicle forwards. Now, lots of things work like that. When a bird flaps its wings, what the bird is doing is pushing down on the air and that makes the bird lift up. Now, you can't fly because you're too heavy and you know you don't have wings. But you might be able to swim. And if you swim and go into the water, if you do the breaststroke, when you push backwards on the water, that makes you go forwards. And that's just the same as with a rocket. When hot gases come out the bottom of the rocket, they push it upwards. Now with the balloon racer, the air in the balloon goes through the straw and it's shooting out backwards. And that pushes the whole balloon and the car in the opposite direction, which is forwards.
Whoa! Oh my word, crash.
So what you do is you blow through the straw.
I know.
And then, what do you think is going to happen if I let go of the balloon?
It'll move.
Which direction?
That way.
Making and racing balloon cars is a great way to get children thinking like scientists and engineers. Handling the different bits and pieces used to make the cars gives children an opportunity to think about the properties of materials. Trying to make the cars go faster or further challenges them to solve problems and think how changing one thing affects another. This is your basic model balloon car, and it's really easy to make. I've got everything I need in front of me here. I've got two straws, which are going to be my axles, and this piece of cardboard that I've cut is going to be my base. So the first thing I do is I sellotape my axles to the base of my vehicle. So I tape that one on there, and another bit of tape. So that's my axles on the bottom of my cardboard. Now I need to affix my wheels, and I'm using these wooden kebab skewers. You can see that I've trimmed the length down. And for the wheels, I'm using these green milk bottle lids. Now the really good thing about these lids is these skewers go through them really easily, and they also seal on it as well. So they stick well. So that's one, and I make a hole in the other one, and push it through. And let's push that one on there. So I put that through my straw. And there's my other wheel. And there you go, there's one. For the other one, exactly the same. So there's my vehicle, and you can see it rolls backwards and forwards. Now I've got to put the engine on. Now what I'm using is this balloon, of course, and a straw. Now the good thing about this straw is it's bendy, so I can tilt it up. Now what I'm going to do is connect the balloon to my straw with a piece of masking tape. So I put my straw in, and now I have to sellotape my engine to my vehicle. Now you have to do it so that you've got the end of your pipe hanging over the end of your cart. I'll tape it on with a bit of masking tape. One, and two, and there we go. All I've got to do now is start the engine. Three, two, one.
I knew it. Bash.
Who's went further?
Me.
And which one went faster?
Mine.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you think we should have a race and see?
Yes. Yeah.
You think it was faster the other time?
Yes, it was definitely faster.
Yeah, I think we, do you think we should try it again and see? Best of three.
I am using a force.